ഇപ്പൊ ഞാൻ ഒരു പാർട്ടിയോ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ അങ്ങനെ ഒരു ഇതിൽ നമ്മൾ കലയെ കാണാൻ പറ്റില്ല. അത് ജേർണലിസ്റ്റിന് മാത്രമേ നമുക്ക് ആ അളവുകോലും കൊണ്ട് നമുക്ക് ഡീൽ ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റുള്ളൂ.
Hello and welcome to Argument to Podcast, and wishing to all the viewers a happy Independence Day. And since we are recording on the Independence Day as well, and you must be very surprised because we have a new guest on our podcast. Actually, this is like a new series where we're talking about several movies and books as well, and also other kind of pop culture as such, which is very socially relevant to the current times as such. So I'd like to welcome Varun Menon. He is actually a third year BTech student. And we share the aspects of how movies essentially shape each one's characters and lives. And also, he's a great movie buff. So, Varun, welcome to Argument to Podcast. And I hope you're doing well.
Yeah. Hey, Joel. I'm doing great. Thank you for the introduction. So, yeah, I'm interested in movies. So that's why Joel called me. We've been friends for some time now. So this is, I'm guessing, just going to be a conversation about a particular movie that Joel has selected. And just a normal conversation. We don't claim to be any kind of experts or anything of the sort. We're learning with you guys. So yeah, great to be here.
Yeah. So like Varun said, we aren't claiming to be any experts in the field, but this is just our interpretation or our perspective with regard to the movies. And today's movie, by the way, is actually a Malayalam movie called Left, Right, Left. It was released way back in 2013, if I'm not wrong. And it is written by Murali Gopi. He's actually a scriptwriter in Kerala, and he's worked with several Malu movies as well, especially those which kind of has a balance of commercial elements and also a lot of political, and also it's a lot more well-written scripts he has done, especially movies like Lucifer. Then you have movies like Kamarasambhavam, and also with regard to this movie, a particular movie as such. So his aspects, especially with regard to politics and the current social climate, also does match the topic at hand. So also this particular session, it will be a mix of Malayalam and English and here and there, but mostly it will be in English, so don't need to worry about that. But at least for a brief moment of time, we'll also be like several terms also will be appearing as well in the podcast. So yeah. So Varun, I think this particular movie, when it came back, when it was in 2013, don't you think some movies or do you think some movies actually have a greater shelf life as such? Once it was released in 2013, the kind of recognition it gets is a lot. Like any movie in particular, this is just an example, but any movie in particular, why do you think some movies are recognized many years later, and what's the particular significance of that?
Yeah, I guess like when you see, like, I think that usually movies that are made for, you know, completely commercial purposes usually have a shorter shelf life. So it'll come out with a huge bang right after it, you know, right after it comes out, a lot of people watch it, and then it dies down. But certain movies, you know, it picks up after some time because of particular things it talks about. Or something which is, you know, maybe a movie is very socially, you know, with the times, or something which is which talks about a particular social thing that recurs. So that's when I think it comes back. So I personally didn't know about this movie. Joel told me about this movie. So like I learned of it a month ago, I guess. And that is when I watched it for the first time. So it is still relevant. It talks about communism, right? We're talking about left, right, left, left, right, left. So it talks about communism, which is still there in India and particularly in Kerala. And, you know, that's why, because it has a particular, you know, it talks about a particular thing that is still here, and that keeps coming back. That is why we probably... it has a bigger
shelf. That's a very pertinent point, because communism as an ideology does seem a very ideal, like it does seem to be a very ideal thing, you know. Why should always the bourgeois or the elites always get the entire facilities? It should be redistributed to everyone. But especially with regard to the movie, Varun, I think you must have also noticed some some characters which does have some uncanny resemblance to today's society. Other allegedly, what we would be like, see, viewers also take note, we would be referring to the real life characters, and it's allegedly because it's not a biopic, and neither are we attributing it to any real life person living or dead. But it's just an alleged notion that it can be a character. So I'll just be introducing the cast members, or at least the characters, the main characters. There are three important characters, if I'm not wrong. So there is the politician who rose up from very grassroots level. So his name is Kaidiri Sahadevan. The second character is actually an ex. I can't say an ex-communist leader, but then he still has a lot of communist ideals in him, but then he's kind of like retired, or he's kind of like in that particular phase wherein he's living in this house along with a professor, an assistant lecturer as such. And he's kind of like gone away from active politics, and he's just living a dormant life as such. And the third character is completely opposite these two characters, because at least these two characters have at least some kind of political backing, but then this character is actually a police officer, and he is the most apolitical person you could ever see, because either he follows someone's orders or he goes by what his own will is, so he will do accordingly to what he says. So I think, don't you think that, you know, how far does politics really shape one person? So, example, that apolitical person in the end is what. So, also viewers, it's going to be like a mix of spoilers as well. So, we would love you to watch the movie, but also during the session, you'll be able to get a more enhanced perspective with regard to the movie as such. So, Varun, like, do you, like, in many instances, do you really attribute yourself to be a lot of politically inclined in nature, or do events or circumstances enable you to act politically in some instances as such?
Maybe, like, I guess it depends from person to person, you know? Some people have a greater inclination to being political, like, because of certain, you know, certain things they've learned from their childhood or something like that. Mm. Some people, like, P.K. Jain, that you talked about in this movie, who is the policeman. Hmm. He is he initially isn't political, as you said. Like, he has one line also which he says that he'll thrash people who wear yellow, red, any color. I don't care. I don't care. I just go with, like, whatever gives me money or something like that. So of course, all of this is again based is because of his childhood, because in his you know, the a sequence where we are shown his childhood. Hmm. At the end of that sequence, they say that he learned two things from one particular momentous day in his childhood. One is that you need to be a police officer because you can, command authority and make people do what you want. Hmm. And second is you have to be rich, because his family didn't have enough money, right? Huh. So these were the ideals that he learned as a child. So he carried that on into his, you know, adulthood. And he didn't really. Some people may, because of these, inclinations or these experiences that he had as a child, some people may become communist. But he just went on, with these two ideals and nothing else, so that he can make money and lead a life where he can keep his mom happy. Hmm. But his experiences after the movie starts, after once his adulthood starts. His experiences change, right? We see that. So, because of his experiences at the end, he becomes probably someone who is hailed as a revolutionary.
Yeah.
Like, completely political, like, from one end to completely the other end. So, it depends on experiences and childhoods, I guess. What do you think?
I've seen, like, if you remember that police officer when he didn't have the money to sustain for his sister for giving her the oxygen as such. So it was a good act police policeman was collecting money from one person who had parked, I think, parked in the wrong side. So in order to, this is actually in the beginning of the movie when you're trying to introduce a character. So this particular scene is where the sister of this police officer is actually kind of almost on a deathbed kind of situation, like out to the hospital. It was a very worst kind of time. And then you're trying to support her with oxygen, but then since there were a lot of patients, the oxygen was used by someone else. So here the policeman, he had actually taken, he saw the plight
of Robin Hood kind of situation.
I'm doing a good thing, but also in order to do a good thing, I have to do something really bad to get to that point. So I think, I don't know, what he thought of it is like, maybe he thought of it, okay, money can achieve anything, but also the ideal thing should have been like helping should have been the ideal thing, what he should have learned from that particular aspect of the police guy taking the money from the guy who parked in the wrong side or caused some disturbance. Mm. And then that guy went and paid, but then by the time the sister died. But then what he carried forward was that, okay, fine, now money can actually help me to take me on forward. Though towards the end, his perspective really changed as such. I think, I would not blame the, like if one particular aspect of the movie is that I would not blame that, like, communism cannot be very ideal in Kerala in particular, especially if you look at it, the reason
why... You mean very realistic in Kerala?
It's a little more realistic because, see, I'll tell you, land reforms, education and health, Kerala does top the thing. But then, especially with regard to industrialization and especially with regard to economy, something which Kerala really goes backside. But then, I feel that, see, these ideas are very good, but then just like that character of that Kailash Satyadevan person, he also, you know, he goes according to, he also kind of shifted, especially drastically shifted from his ideologically, like what is supposed to be, like, you know, this welfare person working for the labor class and stuff like that. And he also takes up the bribe, especially with regard to the case. This particular character, the Kailash Satyadevan character, is allegedly based on the current chief minister, who's Pinarayi Vijayan. And it seems that
it's pretty much Kailash Satyadevan, as Joel said, is allegedly Pinarayi Vijayan, right? So even the case in the movie reflects a case in real life. So many people who've been, like, you know, following along with the news from like 1990s, not my age, I guess, then those people will know about this case called SNC-Lavalin case. Which was basically a hydroelectric project, like three hydroelectric power projects in Kerala, in Idukki. So apparently, allegedly, there was a kind of a scam which cost the Indian exchequer like 374 crores. And people say that Pinarayi Vijayan took a commission for this from the, you know, SNC-Lavalin, the company that was responsible for the hydroelectric project. He took a commission for whatever certain favors he probably asked. We don't need to go into details, but basically the story revolves around how Kaideri, in Left Right Left, the story revolves around how Kaideri Satyadevan, who is Pinarayi Vijayan allegedly, he basically takes commission for this. So basically corruption or Malayalam parna kaikuli. So he's taken kaikuli, and so ideal communism does not, you shouldn't take kaikuli. That's not how communism works. Pakshe, some people in the Communist Party leave the Communist Party and investigate this further and come up with, you know, proof that Kaideri Satyadevan has actually taken commission or kaikuli for this case, for this hydroelectric project. And that's, of course, wrong. So they try to out him. He's not a proper communist.
Because he also has one famous line in the movie, you know. Epporum left, 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 epporum left, right, left in the lever.
Yeah, he's basically jumping the line between left and right. He's, you know, one particular thing he says, if you want to beat the bourgeois, you have to be bourgeois up and down. So you need to be worse than the bourgeois to beat the bourgeois. So So yeah, he's not the right communist, like a correct, you know, an ideal communist or an ideal Marxist or anything of the sort. Pakshay, you know, you could say that realistically, this is the kind of thing that works, because he says that TTIP Ortnengil, if I want to, you know, grow my party economically and as a, like take people with me and stuff, I need money, and this is the only way I can get money. Mm-hmm. So according to him, that's how he justifies his actions. So, but like, and according to him, he has a particular goal. Mm. His goal is to have the Communist Party, you know, Communist Party be the party in Kerala and lead its way, make Kerala bigger, whatever. Whoever comes in his way, maybe it's the idea. It can be, you know,
maybe the ideal communist also can
throw. Yeah. It can be anyone. Congress or Anigilam, even the ideal communist. Maybe even if Marx comes now, he'll probably tell him to get lost because he's in his way. He has a goal and he'll do whatever it takes. So that's his communism. That's what he sees. That's how he's like, you know, that's the only way he thinks that it can be achieved. Yeah. So that's the story of Kaide Sahdev. So yeah. Where do we start, actually? What is the conversation about?
Even because the ideal communist, as one might say, was the people who had investigated on his piece, and also the central character, that is the Murali Gopi character. So he might be the...
Probably the people who investigated on his piece are I don't think they're true communists either. A lot of they do the investigation, okay. But actually, you know, the Suresh Kumar character, he keeps on talking about how his press has to publish this and his press has to get make money. There again, communism matter boile. So being an ideal communist is hard, and I think you know, Murali Gobid character Roy is probably the closest, but not quite. So he also says that, you know, you shouldn't. An ideal communist would stand with the ideal concept of communism. Like, so he also sways in order to keep the party, you know, still in Kerala. Otherwise, if the Communist Party of India goes and that complete coalition goes, then there's only Congress and the right. So he's again not an ideal communist. I guess there's no ideal communist.
Because that's probably the... So his character's name is Che Guevara Roy, and Che Guevara, as you all know, is like the revolutionary of sorts, and he was I think on many of the Indian flags you'll see that particular picture is actually the Che Guevara, and someone who wants to bring change or like a revolutionary. But then it's kind of like an irony I felt, because towards the end, like after his college life, he was very silent. He doesn't have that same vigor and the same spirit as before
when Fire he was college days.
Firebrand character is not there. He's a lot more silent, because there was actually a particular incident what happened to him during his college scene.
Yeah. He was probably, again, a man is made because of his experiences. So he was just, initially he was this Firebrand guy. That's when they started calling him Che Guevara Roy. Che Guevara Roy. So probably the one thing that really, you know, put a blow into his Che Guevara-ness is probably the, you know, he was basically slashed, right? With he was attacked by allegedly Kaide Sahadevan. Not allegedly, actually, at the end they do say that it's Kaide Sahadevan. So Kaide Sahadevan actually saw that Roy, which is Murali Gobi's character, was, you know, rising up the ranks in the Communist Party. And he would, Kaide Sahadevane Vellam Vandi, Werner Alapal. He saw
whoever
him as an enemy.
Whoever comes in front of him, if anyone...
He saw him as an enemy. Turtu. Atrayalu. Were a discussion on the left. So, as we said before, Kaide Sahadevane, anything that comes in his way, he just removes them. He'll do whatever it takes to get rid of them, or basically have him as the leader of the Congress Party. So Kaide Sahadevan attacks him, and he's left with, you know, a paralyzed left foot and an ailing, you know, body. He has like constant heart problems, and that's pretty much why he dies as well, stress him, because of his heart problems that were caused by this. So yeah, so because of this particular incident, he was probably mellowed a lot. You know, no one wants to be slashed with a few knives. Or so
because our flag scene, if you remember, because I think even many of my relatives see, like once if any party puts a flag or a flag posted college, if they put it inside the college premises, it'll be band. It'll be like that. Okay, fine. It'll be like one strange scene wherein it's kind of like an infighting. So what the character of
here
was shown that at the Ramesh Pisharedi, actually an actor in Kerala, and his character was
BBVP.
BBVP is what is mentioned here.
BBVP, BBVP.
But allegedly it's what is called ABVP in the ABVP. Current context. It is a more right-centric student union of the Sangh Parivar as such. And I suppose occupy it's a lot more enmity between these two unions, but then it was through the Kailas Sadevan guy, through this BVP guys got this Murli Gopi's character, that is the Chekuvara Roy character, attacked, like he got him injured. Like usually the Kailas Sadevan character might kill somebody, but then since like if you could, I think if you remember the movie also, like he tells that, you know, because I respect your father, that is why I have not really killed you as such. But then, then we never thought that he was the one who attacked him. But then till that point, with the Rocky fan, he's attacking other attackers, but he's giving a warning to the Murli Gopi character if he's trying to go against him in any form.
Yeah, he says this when he was met the two press people who outed his scandal, averred against Dele. So Aliyar and Suresh Kumar. Yeah, he says this against. So yeah, he's the one who did this, which is sad. But
use your enemy to attack an enemy. So like your enemy, the quote is there, enemy of enemy is your friend.
Yeah, pretty much. BBBP is his friend. I guess he says this like out in the open as well. At the end, you know, he says Communist Party to ullile. End against a fight in Alkarane, ettom villi enemies. So he says that out in the open. That's absolutely no issue, sir. So yeah, that's his approach. Whoever comes in your way, especially if it's someone who's close to you, everyone who has a different thought process is gone. There's only one thought process, and it's his thought process. But he will take care of the people who work with him very well. That's what his father taught him as well in his like our childhood sequence limb. He says, keep like, you know, I'm gonna whoever's close to you, you have to keep them satisfied, if for a lack of a better word. So that's what Kaide Sadevan's principles are.
Kaide Sadevan's uncle, if I'm not wrong, his uncle, I think, got killed.
Ambu Sagar.
This guy, Kaide Sadevan's father, was like, when people are trying to close the eyes of, like, in order to stop the Kaide Sadevan guy from seeing his uncle's dead body, this guy, like, his father was like, don't close his eyes, he must see all this. And I think it also showed a very gradual step from what he was, and like from very kind of a very poor background, like working in the fields, and then to this mass leader and someone who uses the bourgeois to be the who acts those are communists. He can be classified as one who's very close or likely to be a bourgeois of kind. So our systematic change is also happening, is what you notice, right? Because have the tussle also is there between him and the what's the Vijay Raghavan guy's character? Vijay Raghavan's character?
SR.
So I think SR
who
also
is allegedly
VS Achalanandan.
VS Achalanandan. Yeah.
This movie has got a lot of names, characters, events, everything almost true. I'm just surprised it is allowed to release.
Kudos to the team. I didn't expect this at all. Like itaraim. You know, so close to reality and everything, like Canadian company. And then this, you know, the way it is, SR acts like Achyutanandan, and this Kaide Sadevan speaks like Pinarayi Vijayan. And walks like Pinarayi Vijayan. SR walks like Ashwin. It's like it, they've done everything like to the, you know, they've kept it as close as possible. Only name changes. So you know, even like AKG becomes PKG.
Yeah, PKG. Yeah, AKG
also. And CPIM becomes what? RPI.
RPIM
becomes RPI. Yeah, and Arival Chittiga Nakshatram becomes Arival. Only Arival. So
what about the character of like those press people? What like do you think, like in the like in my thought process is that I think okay fine they were expelled out of the party, but then how far does
not
that harm the party? I think they were expelled.
No, Aliyar was expelled. Aliyar was expelled. Suresh Kumar stepped on. Aliyar was expelled because he talked against Kaideri Sahadevan, and Kaideri Sahadevan does not stand there. And Suresh Kumar came out of the party voluntarily. Yeah, anyway.
No, but how far do you hold allegiance to a party which you leave? Because they were still telling that. Because they're like, because these guys, they actually, because they, like in the movies, it shows the constant tussle between the SR character that is allegedly based on VS Achyutanandan and the Kaideri Sahadevan character, which is allegedly based on the current chief minister. And so these guys go to the SR character along with Murali Gopi, because Murali Gopi knows them. They were like in the same college or they were in the same union as such, and they went and approached the SR character. And because they're the ones who broke out the story about the scam, and they went to this SR character because he would have guided them on how to publish the story as such. And in the moonam page le pair
eduthada moonam page le pair eduthada rendu kolathile that's what he said. So basically make it as anonymous as possible and as small as possible, then I'll make sure that you guys won't be attacked or anything. They didn't listen to this. Even Roy suggested this because he was concerned about, you know, he's a little more practical in this sense. So he suggests that they do it as SR says. And SR is someone who has high standing there, so he can back them if he wants to, and they'll be safe. Pakshay, they didn't listen to him. They did it. His face also, right?
Full face in this thing.
Yeah.
Because the paper's name also was the communist.
The communist, yeah. So they didn't believe the Communist Party or RPIM. They didn't leave it because they didn't believe in communism anymore. They left because they didn't believe in what RPIM professed as communism anymore. They believe that they were the true communists. So, anyway, they published this and then they were
both
killed.
Both got killed. Pretty much.
SR turned
against them. No, because he also very tactfully told that, you know, I told that you can publish it, but I gave you a few instructions to publish it.
Yeah.
But so I'm not directly responsible.
Technicality. Like after that, one would expect that, okay, they didn't publish it. They didn't publish it as he wanted. But Shandalam, he can at least stand with them to a particular, he won't be affected by I'm guessing he won't be affected by a huge amount. Like, if he says that maybe this is for the better of communism, he stood against Kaideri Sahadevan, but he didn't stay as far as with the party, with the journalists who outed Kaideri Sahadevan. So he was right in the middle, as you should be, I guess, to live. So he just said that I don't know anything. If Kaideri Sahadevan, this has to be this has to be investigated. This has to investigated thoroughly, and this has to be investigated thoroughly. And depending upon the situation, depending upon what conclusion is brought forth at the end, what conclusion, what it comes to, then depending upon that party le changes varthunna appo ivane basically what he means is kaidesadevinde anengil issue like kaidesadevin anengil if he is the one if he is responsible for this then he should be you know changed or whatever that's of course what he meant so yeah he didn't really stand with anyone
yeah
so because that's why Roy wasn't really happy with him Roy went and met him after that as well but to no avail
it's like situation in olinju maruvanu like just
exactly.
when just when everyone comes to you and
right in the middle so rendu sathike vayalan he is all right so if you know Kaidesadevan doesn't you know isn't Kaidesadevan alla idine karanakaran nu parnal which that comes if that happens then he can stay with the normal RPIM he didn't really say that Kaidesadevan is to blame on it right? so he can stay with him korchaka and avare butter him up a little bit and stay with him otherwise if a matte reethi poyengil he can you know he can take over as well so yeah he played it well it's
oh especially I like that oh, that at sr character that, sorry that the Kaidesadevan character is too good like I don't know what's his name at harish something
harish peredi
harish peredi I think you guys should really watch the movie and really, like the mannerism the way he walks the way he like he's pretty much stiff like he's stiff and then he looks like that but then you literally feel his presence every time
yeah every that, time that's really that's extremely you know every time he's on screen you know he is the commanding character like the dominant one and yeah that reflects even yeah the way he walks as well if, when you see Pinrai Vijayan like whenever he's walking and stuff it's always pretty much the same thing he's really good and hairdo and everything
they've got the specification on top on that but I think like our random characters who got killed one of them do you know that he was actually his wife is currently the MLA in Kerala
random characters nu arna the people the press
the press one the press characters this
Suresh Kumar and Aliyar
this Suresh Kumar character in particular so I think it was based on this particular person called TP Chandrasekhar if I'm not wrong I'll just show you a picture one second just tell me if this scene looks very familiar
oh okay this is that oh this is the one where he goes to you know put the wreath Ritu I can you know pay his respects oh this is
spot on what they've got in the movie exactly they are like in the movie when
in the movie it's slightly different he touches her hand but whatever hand
movie show that after the, like one of the press guys first he dies like he leaves the place and he lives in a very secluded place in order to escape but then somehow they find out and then he's killed when he's roaming in the street and then next day when they are observing the last the final rituals and everything the SR character allegedly based on over here what you see the former chief minister VS Achyutanandan he goes and pays respect and if you go see the video it's very very similar because he holds the hand and then she literally cries and ipo you will be surprised she's actually the MLA of this place in Kerala recently won in the Kerala elections and guess what she's actually the alliance member in the UDF
oh okay I didn't expect that I thought
because like left like it's actually a left party but then it's UDF
yeah I guess it makes sense
So for the viewers UDF and LDF are two different political coalitions like what you have the NDA and the UPA NDA is what you have the majorly is BJP and other allies and UPA is like Congress and other similar allies in Kerala you have UDF which is the United Democratic Front and the LDF which is the Left Democratic Front and Left Democratic Front as you know as the name tells you it consists of mainly the left parties and the UDF is like the Congress and the Muslim League and other smaller parties like the Kerala Congress a few factions of the Kerala Congress again so it's very surprising because I just found out that it is actually a part like I just happened to read like the day the Kerala election got over and the results were announced and the next day I think it came in the Hindu somewhere in the editorial column I guess so she kept on contesting that same in the place, but then finally she won, and it's a very remarkable story for a fact, because I think she had, because it's, as you know, her husband was actually allegedly killed by some of the CPI cadre, or the member of this of the party, and she literally went against, and Shikle party had gotten the seat. So that's a pretty remarkable.
Interesting. Again, real life and the movie is very close.
This is very daring. I'm just wondering, how was it even allowed to get passed through them? Because it gets the SNC correct. It gets this thing correct, wherein they kill the TP Chandrasekhar guy. Though I think this was about the press and releasing the paper. That the other one, you know, in real life, again, this TP Chandrasekhar guy actually left the party, and he formed a new party, and that's why, and some issues happened.
Called RPM. RPM is a new party.
So the RPM in the movie is what RPM was. What this TP
RPM is the RPM in the movie is DPIM, right?
Yeah, CPIM, but then I think in real life, these guys, TP Chandrasekhar guy, I think he formed and started a new party called RPF, if I'm not wrong. So that's how they tried to pull it out in the movie as RPM. Maybe I'm correct on that. And this is one thing that I really noticed. Like, after I watched this movie just before the election, I happened to, I kept on listening to that about this movie. Like, you know, it's a cult classic. It wasn't really recognized in its time. So, especially during the election, I just happened to watch this movie, and then I recently tended to watch the movie. Do you think the lady character was portrayed more of a gold digger kind of a thing? The
Ramya Nambishan's character.
Yeah, was she?
That is one thing I did not understand. I think maybe she's, maybe she's like an apolitical version of Kaideri Sahadeva. Do whatever it takes. Do whatever it takes to get your girl. So she uses so many people on her way. It's like a joke. She uses so many people on her way. But the reason why she's doing it to Arnal, no one would blame her to an extent. But her husband, her husband basically doubts her loyalty, and doubts that her son is his son as well. And he, instead of just divorcing her or whatever, he physically and mentally abuses her and their child as well. So angana parnal, if someone does that to me, I would do whatever it takes to get out of it.
The level she went to, first she used that, befriended the police officer, and that guy, I feel really bad for him, because he felt that he actually liked him and stuff like that, and that's how, because he wanted protection, essentially because this husband character, I think, was in Nimhans, if I'm not wrong, and then he was coming back to see her, so she felt that he might come and attack her, so I think she would kind of under the protection of this police character, felt that since he might help her in a way, and then
he did.
He still stuck to the end. He stuck till the end.
He's also not mentally sound. That's what we understand at the end. Like, how do prescription. That prescription with men? Yeah, with the medicines too. So I guess she used him as well. And then after that, she used that pervert as well.
Oh, yeah.
The travel agency.
I was a little off when his accent was like, hey,
I don't
man.
Completely understand that storyline. I don't know why they had that storyline. Not a main three characters, connection.
I think it was capitalism versus
the full length will be available on YouTube, and also you'll be able to find our latest updates about the session as well on Instagram and other platforms as well. So do like, share and subscribe to our channel on YouTube, and also follow our Instagram page with regard to regular updates as well.